It's like he asked.
Ask him where they're from.
What are you doing?
Ask him what's in his cargo. It killed his people.
Sure. Enough. David.
You made it here. And it was meant for us. Why?
Sure, enough. For God's sake, shut her up.
Was it? I need to know why. What did we do wrong? Why do you hate us?
If she opens her mouth again, shoot her. David, continue. Tell him why I came.
Idrach, manamai. Kyana murtu steda. Uiva, pon itam sostater kreda.
It is the world that has been pulled over your eyes to blind you from the truth.
What truth?
With antagonisms of the moment, we often forget how much unites all the members of humanity. Perhaps we need some outside universal threat to make us recognize this common bond. I occasionally think how quickly our differences worldwide would vanish if we were facing an alien threat from outside this world.
The bottom line here is that over the past several decades, we in the Department of Defense and the intelligence community have been noticing things in our airspace that don't have wings, they don't have cockpits, they don't have even an obvious sign of propulsion like an engine, and yet still they're able to defy the natural effects of Earth's gravity.
In December, ex-CIA Director John Brennan said it was arrogant to believe there are no other forms of life other than the ones on Earth.
Mr. President, designation top secret. We believe a UFO has crashed into the moon. We think the Russians are onto it as well.
And with it close to Earth, she says the moon may have a hint of red, but don't be surprised if it isn't pink.
However, the Pentagon was unwilling to confirm these three photos, which Korbel says came from the USS Omaha, showing a UFO diving into the ocean and disappearing.
That is an extraordinary piece of technology. Whoever is operating these technologies are far more advanced than anything we have in the U.S. arsenal, and that should be a warning sign.
The biggest, brightest supermoon of the year is set to make an appearance. The pink moon, as you see here, will look bigger since it's the closest to the Earth.
It's when the moon's orbit is closest to Earth. It's going to appear larger and brighter, about 13% larger and 30% brighter.
And yet, I ask you, is not an alien force already among us? What could be more alien to the universal aspirations of our peoples than war and the threat?
So this is something I feel like, if I was the president, and it's unlikely that that is ever going to happen.
You never know.
If I was the president.
It was unlikely that I was going to be president.
The moment I was inaugurated, my hand would just, it'd still be hot from touching the Bible, and I would immediately race to wherever they have the files about Area 51 and the UFOs. Yeah. And I go through everything to find out what happened.
Right.
Did you do that?
That's why you will not be president. that's the first thing that you would do.
It's at the
aliens won't let it happen. You reveal all their secrets. They exercise strict control over us.
Now, you know, there are a lot of people that are going to examine your facial expressions here, every twitch, everything, and say, and of course, so did you look? Did you see? Did you explore?
I can't reveal anything.
Oh, really? Because President Clinton said he did go right in, and he did check, and there was nothing.
Well, you know, that's what we're instructed to say.
Well, if you dig deeper into the big pandemic bill and spending package passed late last year, you'll see an unusual demand.
Yes, U.S. intelligence agencies have less than 6 months to tell Congress what they know about unidentified aerial phenomena, or what you and I might call UFOs.
Yeah, so I obtained and released videos and photographic evidence of UFOs swarming our warships. So the green video is night vision. That's from the USS Russell. It wasn't just one pyramid-shaped craft. It was multiple. These were swarms. I also released with my mentor in journalism, George Knapp, also released from the USS Omaha, which looks like thermal imagery. He released three photos the day prior to mine. So we're trying to get this out to continue elevating the conversation.
But first I want to ask you, this is a question that I think is very important to me and very important to the country. When you were in office, and I don't know when this happened or if it happened, did you go through the secret files, the UFO documents? Because if
Maybe.
I was president, that'd be the first thing I did.
You know, it's funny, my daughters asked the very same question.
They did?
Yeah.
Would you be allowed to tell your daughters what was in those files?
No.
You would not?
No.
Now that you're out of office, you can do anything you want, right?
True, yeah. But I'm not telling you.
You're not telling me. You're not telling me what? Are you not telling me that you looked at them?
I'm not telling you nothing.
Are there really great secrets that you know that you can't share with people?
Yeah.
Yeah, there are. And you never write about them?
No.
Maybe at a time in your life,
no.
You're like, oh, I'm 90, I'm going to do it.
No.
No, nothing. What if you were to get, like, a little, like, loopy, you know? You get old and...
Start drinking
you
again?
Start drinking again. Guillermo, get some tequila.
Yeah.
In night vision video from a Navy destroyer, a mysterious flying triangle above the deck of the ship, the Pentagon confirming the images obtained by documentary filmmaker Jeremy Corbell were taken by Navy personnel, expected to be a part of a report on unidentified aerial phenomenon to be presented to Congress this summer.
We're talking about objects picked up by satellite imagery that are difficult to explain.
What do you think it is?
I honestly don't know. I don't think that we have developed that technology. I don't think we developed it on this.
Before you leave office, will you let us know if there's aliens? Because this is the only thing I really want to know. I want to know what's going on. Would you ever open up Roswell and let us know what's really going on there?
So many people ask me that question.
I know, it sounds almost ridiculous, but it's actually the real question I want to know.
It sounds like a cute question, but it's actually, there are millions and millions of people that want to go there, that want to see it. I won't talk to you about what I know about it, but it's very interesting. But Roswell's a very interesting place with a lot of people that would like to know what's going on.
So you're saying you may declassify? Oh. You'll take it?
Well, I'll have to think about that one, right?
Finally tonight, in the race for president, one candidate is fighting hard for a rare demographic, UFO enthusiasts. Recent comments on opening up the X-Files and the mysterious Area 51 have some calling this politician the ET candidate. Here's ABC's David Wright.
The truth is out there, and now the X-Files are a campaign issue, as Hillary Clinton told the Breakfast Club radio show.
Now, if you become president, are you really going to tell the truth about UFOs?
I have said I want to open the files as much as we can, but there are enough stories out there that I don't think everybody is just sitting, you know, in their kitchen making them up.
She's talking, of course, about the top secret files on whether space aliens are real.
If not conventional aircraft, then... what did they see?
Did a UFO crash land in Roswell, New Mexico? And what's the truth about Area 51?
I have seen a red object that flew vertically up from the Area 51.
Clinton apparently keeps an open mind. Recently, when UFOs came up on Jimmy Kimmel, she corrected his terminology.
And you know, there's a new name. It's unexplained aerial phenomenon.
No comment on the issue from Sanders or Trump.
You really believe that story?
That story happens to be highly classified.
A highly classified lie.
But Clinton's enthusiasm is winning over one part of the electorate. Finally, tweeted one sci-fi fan, she has my vote. David Wright, ABC News, New York.